Hello all, a warm welcome from ThinkLateral channel. In this video we are going to learn how to select journal for publication. All the websites which we are going to discuss in this presentation can be accessed through the links given in the description of this video below. There are three important steps. First step is arranging the list of the journals from which you are going to select the journals. Then second step is, out of the journals some parameters should be assessed. Then in the third step we should look at whether the journal is a predatory journal or not. So step one is, I am going to show how the list of journals can be gathered. For this there are various ways. The most easiest and the convenient way is to ask your colleagues, seniors or field experts. The second is this technique, that just to type in Google search your subject, not the topic of your article, but that when you type your subject with the journal, then the list of journals will appear. For example, here I have put up public health journal, display the public health journals related. We have to select one among these journals. Then third way is to go for the journal finder, which is offered by janebiosemantics.org, where you can type either the title or the abstract here. For example, if I am typing pregnancy and anemia, that is my title supposed to be. If I am going to type the journals, will appear here. So these are all journals which can best published. These journals will best publish title with pregnancy and anemia. So like janebiosemantics.org, Elsevier also provide a journal finder with this link, so where you can type the title, paper title or abstract or the keywords or the field of the research, and you can refine your search based on the publication type, journal impact factor, review and publication time, and then you can go for the fine journals where you can filter some journals where the publication fee is more or publication time more, then you can filter out those journals. Then the third is the similar to the Elsevier, Springer Nature also provides this journal suggester where you can type either your title or your manuscript text or the subject area. Again, the same way you can refine your recommendations, the impact factor, minimum acceptance rate, maximum time to first decision and indexing services. Then you can click on this suggest journals where you will get the list of journals. Edan's journal selector, where you can, like Elsevier and Springer and Jane Biosemantics, this journal selector service is also provided by Edan's. So that is given with the link which will be given in the description. From Scimago, that is, we can get the journal rankings also based on various parameters. So suppose if I am choosing medicine in against the subject, and in subject category, suppose if I want to look for epidemiology, and then the regions, either the regions can be selected or the countries can be selected specifically, and the types here, journals, if we select here, so it will suggest what are all the epidemedicine under epidemiology, the journals in, suppose if I type Asiatic region, so these are all the leading journals which are getting published from Asia with high SJR, is in that is Scimago journal rank indicator. Based on that, based on multiple factors, they are making this indicator. So in descending order they will list these journals. So that is how you can select the list of journals on your particular subject and refine it to your topic. Then this is one more important website, that is PubMed. Many of the journals mention that they have the PubMed indexing. Either that PubMed indexing may not be valid at this point of time, or they may be predatory and they may portray that they are having PubMed indexing, but genuinely there will not be any PubMed indexing. So we need to access that. We need to check. This is the platform where you have to check whether the journal is indexed with PubMed or not. This is the link for that. Then this is the step. So far we have seen in the step one how to get the list of journals in your subject topic. That is first and foremost is to ask your colleagues, seniors, or the field experts. Then go to Google, type in the journals, the list of journals will appear. So reach out to each of these journals, and this list can be also made with the journal selectors like Jane Biosemantics, Elsevier, Springer Nature, and Edan's site. Then Skimago gives you the rank list of all these journals in the particular region, in particular categories, etc. So this will, in this site we will check whether it is genuinely PubMed indexed or not. So now we are moving on to the second important step, that is after selecting that journal we have to assess those journals based on the following criteria. First is you have to look at the aim and scope of the journal, whether that aim and scope of the journal matches with your topic or not. That is the most important factor in selecting the journal for publication. So then we, if this fits, if the aim and scope of the journal fits into your topic, then we have to proceed. For this, how we can identify is from the name of the journal itself we can identify. Sometimes we have to go to the about the journal, and about us they will give what are all their focus area. So this will give you the focus area. So from this you can identify or guess your article can be published in this journal or not. Then the most important factor is the indexing. Second important step is indexing. So we have to see which are all the journal is indexed with. Here we have to carefully see this journal is registered with the following abstracting partners, and this journal is indexed with this. Whenever they mention it is indexed, this should be considered. This is registered, that they are waiting for indexing, but they will display in their websites. So we should not get biased with this data, but we should look at this. So here what are all the important indexing agencies we want to know means PubMed. That is PubMed is here. Then Scopus is also here. EMBase. But overall with the indexing, this is a good standard journal. So now in India, MCA gives the indexing as Index Copernicus, which will be invariably present in many of the predatory journals. So we can, for the publication purpose, if we are checking Index Copernicus is present, then for the sake of convincing MCA, for the sake of promotion, we can look for only for Index Copernicus. That is enough when it comes to indexing. And then the third factor in the step 2 is the publication fee. You have to see whether there is any publication fee for this journal or not. So how to identify this? Whether in About Us it will be there, or we have to go to the instructions, and instructions we have to see the authors. So currently we are not able to load with the instructions. For publication fee we need to look at this instructions, and we should be very careful that sometimes some journals will mention that there is no publication fee, but there may be some processing fee, which will be a huge amount where small researchers cannot bear. So that also we need to check as a third important factor. Fourth important factor is the turnaround time. That is, when you submit this article, how long they take for publishing. That can, you can select the previous archives the turnaround time can be accessed through the previous archives. Go into the individual journal articles. In that article, when was the submitted, when was the article published, the date, you just compare and you just get to a conclusion of the turnaround time of this journal. Then we have to look at the acceptance rate also. So some journals will mention this acceptance rate. If the acceptance rate is too high, it is going to be a predatory journal. It is too low, the chance of your article getting published is going to be minimal. So with these five factors, that is aim and the scope of journal matching with your topic, second is the publication fee, third is indexing, fourth is the turnaround time, fifth is the acceptance rate. With this, we individually we have to access these journals, and then we have to list. From that list, we have to come to a conclusion which journal can be applied. And remember the fact that at a time one journal should be approached for publication. We cannot do multiple manuscript submissions at the same time. That is highly unethical, which none of the journals encourage. Then the third important step of this presentation is going to be predatory journal identification. So we have two important sites for predatory journal sites. That is, one is the predatoryjournals.com, where you will get the list of predatory journals here. Just to before publishing, you should check the name of the journal here, confirm that the journal is not present here, then you should publish. That is one site. The other site is the Beale's list of predatory journals and publishers. This is the first websites of this kind. So here we have many categories, that is publishers, where there are predatory publishers. There is no standard definitions for predatory journals and publishers. According to me, the definition is very simple. When the journal which actually does not exist or display false credentials, then that journal is said to be a predatory journal. So for example, here we will have list of publishers, predatory journals, and these are all the standalone journals where the functioning of the journal is not existing, or they display false credentials in their websites. And the vanity press is one important concept. That is, how it is different from a predatory journal is, a predatory journal says that there is a peer review, but actually there may be either no review or there will be a flawed review. But in Vanity Press, they say openly that there is no peer review, but they collect this article and they sell it through Amazon to others. So that is called as Vanity Press. The Vanity Press list is also given here, so we can access here. So currently it is not getting opened. So this site link you can open and you can explore before publishing. And what are all the misleading metrics when it comes to the journal standards, that also given here. And hijacked journals list is also given here. This is very interesting to see. That is, the same journal will be present in one website domain, the other website domain will claim that website is the official website of a particular journal, and then it becomes a hijacked journal, and they collect money, they publish, sometimes they even send the hard copy to the authors. So that way the original journals are hijacked. That list is also given here. These are all the list of predatory journals and publishers. With this website, we are ending the step 3. That is, first is the step 1 to get the list of journals. Step 2 is identifying the individual factors among the journals. Step 3 is getting to know about the predatory journals. After completing all these steps, you will be clear to publish the journal. Hopefully this presentation was useful to you. Thank you very much. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please subscribe. Click on the bell icon. Thank you.